Good morning, church. I would like to share a short devotion with you. And this is from Philippians 1, verse 12 to 14. And it is encouraging for us to look at our lives from God's perspective. Paul goes on to write that I am in the prison, and these chains that bind me in the prison, they are for furtherance of the gospel. It's a very good perspective to look at our life, that is my life only for me? Or is my life is being used by God for furtherance of gospel? And then he goes on to add, to say, all in the palace know that my chains are for Christ, are in Christ. My circumstances will show everyone that this person and his circumstances are in Christ. Because we are at peace, we have joy within us, we continue to love, there is no bitterness in us. And my life circumstances can display Christ, and people will get to witness that these believers who believe in Christ, their life circumstances, whether they are however bad they may be, they are for Christ, they are in Christ, and they are for furtherance of gospel. This is the purpose which God uses my circumstances for. Then he goes on to add that these circumstances of mine, my chains, have made other believers bold. Can you imagine our life circumstances can keep us so occupied that I can keep looking at myself? But if I look at it from heaven's view on my circumstances and people around me, heaven's view is that my circumstances are making others bold. Paul could see that others were becoming bold. Then Paul goes on to add that they are now bold in speaking the gospel. They are bold in speaking. My circumstances are giving boldness to others to speak. This is amazing, because we could at times go and disciple people. We may go and teach people, and then it would take them long time to become able and competent and confident to go and share the gospel of God with non-believers. But here, merely my life and my life circumstances are giving people boldness that they can speak boldly. Then towards the end of the letter, Paul goes on to write that all the saints greet you, especially those from household of Caesar. This is a beautiful picture, that Paul is in palace, but he's in the prison within the palace. Now he's testified to all the people in the palace, all the guards in the palace, and he's testified to believers living in that city. Now they have become bold, they are preaching the gospel. And when he goes on to add, conclude the letter, he is saying the saints greet you, and these saints now also have people from the household of Caesar. So my circumstances, which are created to harm me, have landed up winning people who were otherwise supposed to be my adversaries, and they have now become on our side. They have become part of God's kingdom. They have become saints now, and they are greeting other churches, and they are greeting. We receive those greetings which Paul was sharing with the Philippians church then, and we read about them, and we can apply this to our life, that my life circumstances would not only speak to believers now, but will speak to believers for many, many, because these are all eternal things happening to us. They will speak to people for many generations. And when Paul was actually chosen, we read in Acts 9, he was said that he is going to go and share my gospel with Gentiles and with kings. That prophecy that was given to Ananias is now actually getting fulfilled, that here he is in the prison, he is going to testify before kings, he is already testified before two or three kings, and he's now testifying to the whole palace. And we could encourage us this morning that God, whatever is happening in my life, I may not see purpose, but you see a purpose in it. It is your purpose which is getting fulfilled in my life. My life, everything that is done unto the Lord is not in vain. Everything is to glorify God. I may not see it, but it is glorifying God, because God is doing it, and he is getting glorified for those things which are happening in my life. It would give boldness to others. Others could go and preach gospel. people who are our adversary will actually become saints, and they would greet other believers around to say that, you know, they have been saved because they have received the mercy of Christ. They have come into this kingdom of light. And I think as a church, and each person can rejoice, as Paul says, rejoice. And again, I say rejoice. This was the reason for his rejoicing, because he knew what was happening in his life was for furtherance of gospel. And God was using those circumstances to speak to people all around him. And we can thank God for using us not only in good times, also in adversity and at all times. We are eternal beings. We are living eternal life is in us. And what we do is actually an eternal testimony. Thank you. Wish you all a good day.